Hey people, I'm sitting here with a nice Wink Haus half euro sent by Redeye Locksport. Redeye, you legend, thank you very much. As you might be able to see, it has a rather paracentric keyway. Paracentric meaning that the warding in the keyway crosses over the center axis of the keyway. So, that being said, here is the key that comes with this lock. It works beautifully and smoothly, as you can see. So, now that we've had a quick look at the lock, let's get down to some picking. Back with you in a moment. Okay. Excuse me. We're going to have a crack at this thing now.
Thank you.
And we're open. Whoa. Damn. Kept me busy for a while. But we're open. I'll take it. I've opened it a couple of times before. And each time it takes me about the same amount of time. So, well, what can you do? It takes what it takes. So, now, I have not yet looked inside this thing. So now I need to figure out how I'm going to get the back off it. Go. All right, that's the pins all laid out. Let me see if I can get a slightly better view of things, and we'll come back and have a bit of a chat about it all. Back in a sec. Okay, I just took a moment to lay things out on the pinning tray here, and to take a little bit of a closer look at the shell here up in the Bible. And the result of that was I found no modifications up in the Bible, and much the same within the plug. There are no modifications within these chambers either. So that's all straight and forward. Quite nice tolerances with the Winkhaus. A very nice lock. In terms of the internals, for key pins we have all standard key pins. So all is quiet on the home front there. In terms of drivers, we had a nice mixture of different pins, which would be the source of the trouble that I was having. This variation to pins doesn't really give you much to get used to. I mean, you feel a spool and you might think, aha, we're in the land of spools, but then again, the next pin will be different, and the next pin will be different again. So it's quite a nice idea, and it certainly kept me guessing and fumbling around, as you saw. But I'm waffling, so I'll just say that in pin one, as you can see here, we have a standard key pin. And two, we have a nice spool pin. And three, we have what I thought at first when I saw it was kind of an acid barrel type pin, but looking at it a little bit longer, it dawned on me that it wasn't. But what it was a pin with reduced diameter ends. So kind of like a double-ended spool pin of sorts. So something a little bit extra to, one, change the feel, and two, give something to get caught up on, and something to have to search for once you get hung up on it. So moving along, in four, we have another spool pin, but a somewhat shorter one, again, making it a different feel. And in five, we have another standard pin. So, as I said, quite a nice variation, and it worked well to keep me busy and keep me thinking. And last but not least, the springs are all uniform in length. So, nothing so much there to confuse me, but obviously the source of my confusion was with this nice selection of driver pins. Obviously it had quite a nice bitting too, and also, you know, this rather interesting looking keyway. So, all of that being covered, at this point I will say thank you very much to Redeye Locksport for sending this along for me to have a pick at. It did keep me busy, and it did keep me thinking, and it did make me work, so that is freaking awesome. Additionally, I guess it's up to me at this point to say thank you to anybody that watched, and in general to say peace and respect to all of you in the lock sporting community, and hello to anybody passing by. So, I've taken up enough of your time, so peace and respect to all, and I'll see you on another day. Ciao for now.